In this video, we will learn how to essentially make any curve we want. For example, you can see here that with this curve, I have 4 points that I'm using to make this curve look however I want. As you might tell, these curves are extremely useful for us. So, let's jump right into learning how to make Bezier curves. Jumping right into Desmos, Bezier curves are determined by 2 terminal or endpoints with as many points between them. Our curve will have its 2 endpoints be on these terminal points, as you may have guessed, and our points in between will not be on our new curve but will influence it. If we look at this 3-point Bezier curve, by moving our middle point, the curve seems to be pulled like silly putty toward wherever the middle point is. With a 4-point Bezier curve, we have an added level of depth and detail we can make with our curve. I can make infinitely more curves with 4 points than 3 points, but not all curves. Haha, quick reference to another video. After this video, watch this one about infinity if you're interested. You may have aptly noticed that these Bezier curves don't follow the vertical line test. That is, they're not a function. And this is true. This is because Bezier curves are defined parametrically. We can also see this if we look at the formula for a Bezier curve, where our curve is defined by both t and what's that, p? If you've never actually seen it before, p refers to a point, and if we scroll down a tiny bit, I actually have a table of points. These are the points defining my curve. And now, we actually have everything so you can make your own Bezier curve. If you want to know more about the specific math behind the formulas of Bezier curves, I will link some good websites in the description, but for now, I will show you the formulas of 3 and 4-point Bezier curves. You can copy these into Desmos. I will also put them in the description. One thing to note is that I said B sub AZA4 for the 4-point Bezier curve. This is just a name. I could have done B sub 4 or even Q if I felt like it. What we have now is a statement. This won't make a graph, but it will help us a whole lot later. What we do next is make a table of points, and depending on how many points we want, we make that many rows. One important thing to note is that we can make Bezier curves of as many points as we want. We would just need a new formula depending on how many points we have. Now that we have our table, go to a new line and type the name of your curve formula. So I would type B sub AZA4, and then parentheses T, comma, parentheses again, and then the X name of your table, comma, Y name of your table. You will notice this corresponds to where we declared our curve in the formula above, B sub AZA4 of T, comma, P. In this case, the points, or P, is our X name, comma, Y name. This is where it can help to name our table if we have many curves. I can rename my table to be X sub curve 1 and Y sub curve 1 if I wanted. We can also change our curve if we don't like the exact way it looks by moving around the points from our original table by setting them to drag. One more fun thing we can do if we want to fill in the area between two Bezier curves, like so, as long as the endpoints of both Bezier curves are on top of each other, we can use this formula right here to combine the two curves into one line, where we can then change T to go to 2 instead of 1, and go into Customize and then turn on Fill. If you have any questions, make sure to comment them, and if you enjoyed, make sure to like and subscribe, as it helps this channel a lot by recommending this video to others who may also want to watch it. Thanks, and have a great rest of your day.